This is a family in the Wolf organization, and we have a profit sharing plan that shares somewhere between 20 and 30% of the profits of this company with its employees.
It's a very happy place to be in the office when those checks come out in March.
It's pretty amazing to see someone who just starts for the organization and gets that first check.
What better way to say to somebody, we want you to act like an owner of the business, than to give you a share of the profits?
I have a group, a family of people who we each depend on each other to do a good job so that we have that nice profit sharing check at the end of the year so we can sustain good jobs, good compensation, good benefits, and that good sharing of the profit at the end of the year.
My profit sharing check allowed me to take my family of four on a 7-day cruise.
My husband used to watch all my neighbors go out of the neighborhood with their motorcycles, and I actually ended up paying for a Harley Davidson for him in 2006.
One of the biggest things for me probably is I was able to put money back for my daughter.
So profit sharing has been foundational to this organization and really important to a lot of people.
I think if you would talk to my children today, they would remember the cruise that they were taken on for the first time and know that it came from Mom's profit sharing at Wolf.
I would say that Tom does it because Tom just genuinely cares about his employees.
He cares about those that come through these doors every day, and he wants them to feel as if they are part owner of this company.
To the extent any community has strong middle class jobs and a strong middle class, it's a healthy community. When you have a community that is losing middle class jobs, you have a community that's losing its vibrancy and its economic health. And I think Pennsylvania, like every other state, has to do everything in its power to make sure that we're building rather than destroying the middle class.